if you can build a high quality product that people love and you know, communicate with your customers and find out what you can do to make the experience even better for them, then they will spread it to their friends. And so that's the way we look at it, is we just try to spend the time to make the product as high quality as we can, to make it as simple as we can. And we try to have an ongoing dialogue with our customers to try to improve it and make it better based on their feedback. And when you do that, I think that it spreads itself from person to person. And you know, people tell their friends, I downloaded this app, it's really great, it's really high quality, I can share. And you know, it's, in our case, you know, we have a lot of things that other people don't have. We don't have ads, it's safe, it's private, you know, you can depend on it. And you know, we also try to make it very high quality, and the beauty of the interface, and the way that, you know, we go about every little detail. And we think that that kind of is what gets people to tell their friends. And you know, those kinds of things take time. It takes time to create things at a high quality, and you have to be willing to be patient and you know, develop things before you release it. But if you do it that way, I think people tell their friends. I think people appreciate good things and they tell their friends. Several months, last year. I've been here a bunch, and you know, we're here right now. We're interviewing to hire a new country manager for Indonesia. We're going to establish our first international headquarters here in Jakarta, and so we'll start building up an office here to you know, help us to gather feedback, to be more a part of the local community. Establish partnerships, and you know, maybe even long term, have a creative team here to help build local content and products for the local market. You know, the way we look at it, and you know, the reason we're here, the reason that you know our chief of design is here, is that we really care about being part of the local community, and I think that comes from, you know, like I said, I'm from a small town, and you know, I think it's. You know, to be authentically part of the community is the only way you can create a good product. So our goal is certainly not just to be a sales or you know business office here, but longer term, I think we want to create content, want to have partnerships, want to work with people to create things that are good for the Indonesian market, can not only help PATH, but help PATH become a platform so that entrepreneurs here can build on top of PATH, you know, build their own enterprises in the long term. Oh. You know, we have a very simple vision of the future, and that is that social networking in a lot of ways is very inhuman. You know, we're still using text to communicate with each other. If you think about the personal computer, you know, the early days, there was no Windows, there was no, you used a command line, right? You used Microsoft DOS, right? In a lot of ways, we think that we are living in the era of social networking DOS. You know, we use a command line to communicate with each other. We don't use video. It's very hard to have a very personal conversation. And so we still think we have a long way to go in terms of making technology much more human and to communicate the depth of human emotion and the human experience. And so to make technology do that is actually really hard. And you know, we're very dedicated to that. And you know, ultimately the vision of PATH is that we're not just a way for people to connect for the sake of being connected, but we want our technology to actually bring you closer with the people that you care about, and to really deepen those relationships, you know, be a much more human experience. And that's something that I think is still a far away in a lot of respects. So we'll stay focused on that for a while.
Okay. Good.
You know, I was lucky early in my career. I grew up using Apple computers. leaders a lot, and so I think that Steve Jobs had a lot of impact on me as a child. I was lucky, my first job out of college, after I graduated college, was at Apple, and I got to work at Apple when Steve was still alive. He had a really big impact on me, I think, more than probably any other entrepreneur, just in terms of focusing on innovation and quality and simplicity. You know, if anything, the story of Apple, nobody remembers that 10 years ago, Apple was a little 5% market share computer company. They didn't have the iPod, they didn't have the iPhone, and they weren't what they are now. You know, now you look at Apple 10 years later, and it's the most successful, you know, technology company in the history of the world on virtually every metric. You know, whether you look at number of devices, amount of profit, well, you know, every metric, it's the greatest technology company. And I think a lot of that is because of their focus on quality and the user experience. You know, they just constantly focus on how can we make people's lives better and do it over the long term. And staying, I think, focused on that actually is really hard. And Apple, if anything, is a case study in what happens if you focus on quality for a long enough period of time. And so they've been a big inspiration. Here, it seems like people are more willing to start than anywhere else. And so I think that you know, the better advice is to stick with it. Because entrepreneurship is a process and it's really hard. You know, you fail a lot. You fail almost every single day. You know, you're doing jobs and you're doing things which are things that you might not be good at. You have to hire people to help you. You have to find knowledge and find mentorship. And all of these things are really, really hard. And inevitably, along the path of entrepreneurship, you're gonna make really hard mistakes that might set you back a lot. And I think that the best advice is just to trust the process and stay in it. Don't quit, don't give up. There's this famous quote from Winston Churchill that I like a lot. Never, 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 never surrender. I think that entrepreneurship is a lot about keeping going, because, you know, you're gonna hear no from everyone. Everyone's gonna tell you you're crazy. And you're just gonna hear that a lot. And so the only way to keep going is to really believe in what you're doing and keep going as long as you can. That's not to say don't go too long, but, you know, I think that a lot of people just give up. And, you know, you're supposed to encounter problems. That's what entrepreneurship is. You're actually changing things. Ultimately, you're changing the world. And so that's not easy.